She could be the most influential New Zealander in global sport. Sarai Bareman is head of women's football for FIFA, all of it. 211 countries, from South Sudan to the US, from the biggest superstars to girls in places where they can barely afford a ball. Sarai Bareman is the boss. Tonight, John Campbell meets the unassuming Westie Wahine, who's shaping the game around the world and bringing the World Cup right here.
And so this is it. What the last 2 years of preparation have been all about. What dreams are made of.
Yes, dreams and where they take you, like Zurich, Switzerland, and FIFA Global Headquarters, where Sarai Bareman, boss, is arriving at work.
What's your title at FIFA now?
I'm the chief officer in charge of women's football in FIFA. Yeah.
Wow. I actually feel a little bit emotional looking out at this room and seeing everyone here, all for the purpose of women's football. It's so touching.
When Sarai Bareman speaks, they translate it into the many languages of the world's most global sport.
I know that working in women's football is not easy.
FIFA has 211 member countries around the world. It's bigger than the UN.
This for the lead in the 2019 FIFA Women's World Cup final for the holders and reigning champions, the United States.
We're trying to get 60 million women and girls playing our game by 2026.
It's Rapinoe against Van Veenendaal. It's 1-0.
How do I get US, who are already one of the, they're the world champions, they've got a professional league, some of the best players in the world, how do I support them to boost it further? And then on the other side, how do I take a country like South Sudan, newest country in the world, just started 2 months ago, their first ever women's league? How do I support them at the same time? And just this huge, diverse range of stakeholders, all at different levels of the women's game. I had to come up with a strategy on how to support them and how to grow the game at every level.
How do you do that?
That's the million-dollar question.
The multi-million-dollar answer to that came two Fridays ago, when FIFA came to town. Sarai herself, FIFA's Secretary General Fatma Samori, and its president Gianni Infantino, led by Ngāti Whātua Ōrākei, in the first ever such porphyry for the heads of the world's biggest sport. How does FIFA build the women's game at every level? By getting money from the Women's World Cup to be played here and Australia next year.
And FIFA, my job is to make sure that that moment is then used for legacy, for the game, for everything else that happens beyond that when the final whistle is blown. It doesn't stop there for us. It has to keep going.
That's big, eh?
It's huge. It's absolutely massive. And yeah, it's about so much more than just being an event and going to a stadium and watching it. You know, we're trying to create commercial revenue for the women's game that hasn't existed in the past. And the World Cup provides this moment where our players are on TV everywhere, billions of people are watching. There's no better time to sit beside a commercial affiliate and say to them, hey, look at this. Tell me you don't want to invest in this.
And yes, incredibly selling the game, leading the dream, charged with making it all work, is a woman from West Auckland. Sarai Bareman, who represents both the changing face of FIFA and the changing face of the game itself, despite her oval start in sporting life.
Rugby was my first love. It was. You know, I have three brothers. We all played rugby. My dad was a rugby coach. My mum was a manager. Every Saturday, for as long as I can remember, we were down at the Massey Rugby Club, running around in our bare feet, getting muddy, playing rugby.
What was the switch to football about? Why did you switch to football? Was that at Massey High?
Yeah, it was actually. Yeah, I was a bit of a black sheep from my family then when I made the switch over to football.
The switch, one of those moments in which life turns. Sarai was good at football, good enough to play for Samoa, but she found her real footing off the pitch, rising from finance officer to CEO of Samoan football.
At the top end, it was a total different story. Yeah, as a woman, I just wasn't respected just for my gender. You know, I'd want to drive things forward and I would be told, you know, you don't belong here, get back in the kitchen. Really horrible stuff.
In 2013, Sarai Bareman found herself representing Samoa here, and this is the only footage that now exists of it, a Pacific Youth and Sports Conference in New Caledonia. The speech she gave, and there's only two short shots of it, against sexism in sport, changed her life.
And what was incredible after that speech is even before I came off the stage, the women and girls that just absolutely swamped me and said, oh my God, your story, I have the same issue. I'm this person, this happened to me in my country. It was happening everywhere. And they all just jumped on me and were like, thank you for just saying it.
You reckon you are the chief officer in charge of women's football, all women's football, global women's football,
yeah.
In part because you stood up in New Caledonia and said, I am pissed off. Do you reckon that was the turning point?
I think that was the start of a journey, yeah. Absolutely.
Some good tackling by the Canterbury United players, but Johnson still has it.
That was a good
She's
goal.
Good. She's
off the
good.
Left foot too.
Yeah, that's why I love this. This is on the number one pitch. There's a good crowd here. We've got cameras. It's being broadcast.
It was one of those lovely afternoons where sport seems hopeful. Warm spring sunshine, children, a good dog, and a good, tight, spirited game.
So the dream is for you guys to be in the National League?
Yeah, hopefully.
That's so cool.
Dreams again, and how much more achievable they seem since Sarai herself played this game.
Did you ever play here?
I did play here.
Did you?
Although I never got the privilege of playing on the number one pitch.
Was the number one pitch
I was on the field at the back there.
Was it the boys out here,
yeah,
was
exactly,
it? Did the women never get a turn here?
No, not in my
Truly.
Day. That's why this is amazing to me.
Go, Auckland! Go!
Shoot!
After the break, a family catch-up.
I feel that she was destined for this.
I knew that she was a big wig.
Sarai's famous brother and his superstar mate.
What a World Cup!
And celebrities, we're just getting started.
I met Maradona. I met Maradona.
I smiled. That was great.
Back in Zurich, where your identity might easily be subsumed beneath those four big letters, Sarai Bareman never forgets who she is and never stops gently telling the world either.
Tell me about the flower. Because in Auckland, that's not such a big thing. And it's a beautiful thing, but it's not a declaratory statement in Auckland.
Mm.
But in Zurich, what's the flower say?
Well, people ask me where it is if I'm not wearing it. And for me, what it's about, and I make a point of wearing it, actually, everywhere I go, because it reminds me that no matter where I am, I may be in Zurich, I may be in FIFA in this big fancy office up on the hill in Switzerland, but actually who I am is this person. You know, I'm a half Samoan, half Dutch, born in New Zealand, out west. It keeps me grounded. It really does. I don't need to change anything about who I am to adapt to these environments that I'm in. I'm here because of who I am and where I come from, and I don't need to change that.
Hello, my Shatsy boy.
To understand the singularity of Sarai Bareman, her drive, it's helpful to understand where she comes from, that famous surname, that famous brother.
Holding my teeth.
Hi, boy. Hello, son.
Yes, that is Eugene Bareman with Israel Adesanya, globally acclaimed MMA duo, coach and fighter.
All right, before getting to know me, we're going to get to know my coach, Eugene Bareman. Where'd you grow up? Out west.
I was born in Waitakere Hospital.
Proud to be from Messi, went to Messi High School.
Hey, look at me. That's my hood now.
Messi Rugby Club. I know you live in Messi now.
That's my hood now.
Part of the reason you live in Messi is because I let you live in Messi.
Sorry.
How proud are you of your kids?
Oh, very proud. Of all of them, yeah. Yeah. Not just the famous ones.
Dinner prep, a Sunday roast at Eugene's place. A once weekly family get-together now made rare and precious by the fact Sarai, her husband Mark, and their baby Matisse now live in Zurich. There is such joy here.
How proud are you of her?
I'm very happy for her. I'm very happy because I feel that she was destined for this. Because I'm a devout Christian, so I feel that God has a purpose for everyone's life.
And why do you think God's purpose for your brilliant girl was this kind of leadership?
Because he blessed her with the talent for people.
Admittedly, when she first, for the first couple of years, when she had the job, I had no idea what she did. I knew that she was a big wig. But as the years went by and I eventually visited her up in Switzerland and I went to the head office, and it's a big underground multi-billion dollar bunker that they have in the side of this mountain, that I realised that, there's something going on here. You're a real big deal.
It's funny, for a long time when I thought of FIFA administrators, I thought of everyone but you.
Me too. Me too.
It's a sellout at the Parc des Princes.
From West Auckland to Samoa to here, oh, the places dreams take you.
I met Maradona. I met Maradona. And I had to act all cool and shake his hand and be like, hi, da-da-da. And inside, I was just going absolutely nuts. You know, and with my FIFA jacket on, you have to sit there and be cool. You can't be all like, you know.
Yeah.
Pull out your phone and take a selfie. You have to, you know, and that is amazing. I get to have those moments, those incredible moments, but then I also get to be the person that changes the life of this little girl in South Sudan who's never played football before, who struggles to even get the uniform that she needs to go to school, let alone play a sport. I get to be the one that helps her to introduce her to a sport that will change her life forever. And just being able to be in a job that can allow me to do that, I feel like the most blessed person in the world.
When you were playing club football on the outer ground, not even the number one girl, could you have dreamt in your wildest dreams that you would be doing what you're doing now?
Absolutely not. No, I don't even know. Not in my wildest dreams.
Did you even really know what FIFA was?
I wouldn't have
then?
Even known what FIFA was.
No.
I think at that point, I probably thought FIFA was a video game. I didn't even know what it was as an organisation.
Anything is possible. Anything is possible. I never dreamed that I would ever be in the position that I'm in today. I mean, I never even dreamed I would be in Samoa, looking over the football organisation there, let alone FIFA. It's crazy. It's a global governing body of football. I never dreamed it. There's nothing so special about where I came from or who I am. There are so many girls out there that are exactly like me. And I guess what it says is that anything is possible. Yeah. I mean, look at me.
Well, Sarai is now at the Under-17 World Cup in India, and the dreams continue. The Football Ferns will play the opening game of the Women's World Cup at Eden Park in July next year.